Welcome to the Electronics Gadgets channel, $30 or less gadgets. This one is in the upper limit of my price range. It's a $29.99 gadget. And I've seen it as high as $50 on some websites, so it depends where you buy it. My local electronics store has it for $29.99, which is actually a good price if I compare to the web. So this is a little 4x4, it's called the Moto TC Monster. The Moto TC Monster is a little 4x4 remote control truck. Comes in this nice little box. It is a very nice device, as you see here. And it is made by Griffin. And if you go to the Griffin website, actually, you will see this device. But there's more than one. Actually, on the website, there's other trucks. And they even have remote control helicopters. And that will be probably next week, as I've seen that they do have the helicopters where I purchased this. And I will probably get the helicopter also. It is Bluetooth enabled, so it means that in your iPhone, so for example, I got the app in the iPhone 5 that I own here. I'm just going to show you for 2 seconds. So what you do is you actually have the little app, and the app is right here, and I just enabled that, and you see that it has a Griffin logo, and even it has the car sounds. And you have several ways of actually controlling, which is quite nice. You have the controls on the screen, so you can actually have controls here and the wheel here. Or if you want, you can also control by movement. So you just have to, you know, bend it front, forward, backwards, or just turn your device. It uses the internal gyroscopes in the device. You also have touch enable, which means that you can actually just move by going through the screen. I think this is, in the outdoors, I found that this is one of the best ways to actually to control it, because you can really easily send it where you want this way, just by touching the screen. As you hear, every time the car starts or stops, it has this sound of your car starting. And finally, there's this shape thing here. You can have it do an 8, a circle, just wobble in a line. And you can actually also, on the right side, you can actually record your own little track here. So what you do is you record in the device a pattern, and the truck will do that pattern every time you need to actually do the exact same pattern. So it's pretty cool. Let me show you the real device here, because I'm going to show you what it looks like. That was a truck, and here is the actual truck. Now, it's a nice little truck. I would say that I'm a guy that has a lot of little 4x4 trucks that I've purchased through the years, and I like remote control stuff. So like I said, this is Bluetooth, so it's remote controlled by your phone on Bluetooth. It has a range of about 100 feet. The wheels are cool because they are not plasticky. Some cheap trucks have plastic wheels, and plastic wheels have a big problem, is that on the asphalt outside, it slides rather than actually running. There's one flaw on this one, is that sometimes the wheels don't always touch the floor. There's sometimes one of the four wheels, especially in the front, and it's because, you know, the package is quite light, so I think there's just not enough weight on it, maybe. It has this little plastic top, and you see these little metal things here are to hold the frame together, so So you can remove actually the frame from the truck. And the reason you want to remove the frame from the truck is because you need to enable Bluetooth at first. And to enable Bluetooth, you have to go under that frame and actually press a little button that's right here. And that's the bad part, I would say, of it. Let me just turn it on and I'm going to show you that. When you turn it on, there's a light on the right side and a black and a button on the other side. Here we go. So there's the little blinking light here. This shows you that it's actually on. When you press here, it blinks faster, and that means that you can go in your Bluetooth settings on your phone and pair the robot. Now, one thing that that you might want to check is that in the instruction manual, it says that, well, just find Monster on the Bluetooth. Well, mine isn't called Monster. Mine on the Bluetooth, when I actually enabled, was actually another type of device. The name, I'm just going to check here, the name for the device was Beacon. And that's how it's called. So it's kind of weird, because it's called Beacon and not called Monster, and that can cause a little confusion if you're not sure what is a device actually. Now, that button being here, I find it a little awkwardly placed, and frankly, having to take out the top of the truck to just to press that Bluetooth button, it's kind of annoying. But behold, after playing with it and having to actually pair it more than once, because I had it at some point lost its pairing with my phone, I actually noticed that you don't really need to take out the device top. You can actually just put the little middle, here it goes. If you look carefully, you can actually bend just a little bit the top here, and the button is actually accessible right here with a screwdriver, so you don't really need to take off the top if you really need to pair it again. It's nice little design. The plastic is, yes, cheapo, but it is okay, because if you have accidents with it, it prevents it from breaking. Goes at a nice little speed. It's not, you know, the fastest 4x4 I've ever seen, but the speed is okay. What I find a little awkward is the controls. The controls tend to take time, especially if you use the controls that, you know, you move your phone around. That's kind of hard and not always very fun to control it with. And it does sometimes do the wrong thing, which is very weird. You know, you'll just bend over your phone to go forward, and you notice that it doesn't move immediately. It takes like a second to react. There's this sluggishness that's a little annoying on it. But apart from that, you know, especially on the one that you just leave the finger on the screen and move around, that works quite well. And also the automatic process works well. And by the way, check another video that I'll be posting soon, where I'll go outside and actually try it and film what it does live, so you'll see how it works. Battery is there's one battery included, which is this very small 4.8 volts battery that requires the annoying little screw to be removed every time. And I actually tried not to put it, and you have to, because when you get bumps, the cover will actually fall out if you don't put the screw. It's this little battery that's right here, and to charge it, you have a little wall wart where you plug it in. It takes about 2.5 to 3 hours to fully charge, and so it's a little long, and there's only one battery. And it gives you about 15 to 20 minutes of truck. So, you know, that's the drawback. Having one of those batteries means it's a 500 milliamp hour battery. And one of those batteries actually makes only 15 minutes for a 2.5 hour charge, that can be a little boring and annoying. So I suggest that you buy such a battery. Now, the only place where I've seen you can buy one is actually on the website of Griffin. And it's rather expensive, but this is an enclosure with four AAA batteries. So I'm thinking that I might be able to build one myself. I have a few plugs of old batteries. This little plug is kind of universal on many devices, so I've actually used some of those from other packs, battery packs of old radio control devices. The only thing I'll need is try to build some way of putting a four AAA batteries, especially getting higher milliamp power. This is 500, but I've seen AAA batteries at 1000 milliamps. That would technically give you more than half an hour of control. So once it's charged, well, you just put it in and enjoy your device. The pairing with the phone was quite easy, quite fast. Once you press that little button, the iPhone saw the device right away. Like I said, instead of being called Monster like in the instructions, it was called Beacon. But apart from that, it works quite well. Seems to be well constructed, as you see here, with the little chucks and everything here. And I haven't used it, a lot. I've used it for maybe two or three trips of 15 minutes. But from what I've seen, except from the little sluggishness maybe in the controls, it's not too bad. So $29.99 at the local electronics store here. On the web, anywhere from $29.99 to up to $50 on some websites. So we shop around. And it's made by Griffin. And it's the Moto TC Monster touch-controlled monster truck that you actually control with an iPhone, an iPad, and an iPod Touch. So you'll need an iDevice. So if you have an iPhone, iPad, and iPod Touch, why not check this out? If you enjoy our videos, why not subscribe to our channel? You'll be informed when new videos are online. And maybe you have a device that you'd like us to check out and talk about. Let us know. We'll try to, put that video online. And hopefully you enjoy our channel and we'll be coming back. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.